Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to construct an activity diagram for online food ordering system. So let's get started. So for this purpose I'm using Star UML software. You can use any other software or tool to construct your own diagram. So inside Star UML, here at the top you'll be having an option called as model. Click that, and here you'll be having add diagram. Just select activity diagram, and after that you'll be getting all the necessary shapes to construct your activity diagram. I think by default it will have the class diagram shapes. So irrespective of the online system or anything, the first thing that a user performs is going to be login, or if the user is going to be new to that particular website or app, the user needs to register and create an account. So just imagine you're creating a Google account. You first create an account and after that you login. So it's sign up and sign in basically. So first we will be beginning with the initial. Okay, this is the starting point. And I would recommend you to have it at the top because our diagram will go longer. So just have it at the top. And next thing, the action that the user is going to perform is going to be login. Yeah. And here we need to have a decision. Okay. So we need to check whether that user is a new user or an existing user. If the user is a new user, we need to prompt that user to register and then login. So in that place, we will be having a decision over there. So for that, here we are having that decision tool, which is basically like a diamond shaped or a tilted rectangle. I'll just have this over here. And near this, it's better to have a text or something so that we know what this decision thing means. So I'll just go to annotations over here. I'll just click on text, and this is going to be new user. And I'll have two more text, which is going to be here it is yes, and another text is going to have here dash no. Alright. So if the user is going to be a new one, the user will be prompted to register. Okay, it's going to be register, and after registering, the user can just log in again. So we'll be having an arrow line. I will just draw the arrow line once I'm done with the initial phase. Okay. So if the user is an existing user, just we will be knowing if the user is existing or not once the user types the email or mobile number or something like that. So once we have found that the user is an existing user and not a new one, we need to perform the authentication. Okay. So we need to basically perform if that particular password is right or wrong and matches with that email or the mobile number. So it's going to be authentication. And after this, we will again be having a decision box to make sure that if the user has entered the right password for the right email. So if the user has entered the valid credentials, the user will be allowed to go inside our food ordering system. And if a user has entered a wrong password, the user will be again prompted to log in. Like, yeah, have you forgot your password? Enter the right password or something like that. So we'll just again have a decision box, and we'll just have more text. You're just going to have it as valid. If the thing is valid, the user can continue with the work. And if it isn't valid or invalid, the user needs to again log in. Okay, I'll just have invalid over here. So now let me just draw the arrow lines. So it's going to be from this thing to login, and from login to this decision box. From here, if not the new user, authentication. And if the new user, can just click on register, and after register, again login. And here after authentication, we will be having an fork, because after this point the user can perform multiple actions, right? Because till now the user is going on a straight workflow, but after this we will be having multiple actions like order food, check the history, edit details, cancel the order. So there are so many actions that a user can perform from this point. So in that case, from a single workflow, we are going to have multiple workflow for the user. So from a single point, we are going to have multiple arrow lines. So in that case, we will be using this thing called as fork. Let's have this. So we can just expand this like this. Yeah, this is fine. And yeah, this is good. Now let's just continue with our control flow from authentication to here. And if it is valid, I will just have valid down here. It's going to be to this line. I just have, just make sure that it's straight. And after this, from here we need to go to login. So we can just select that line and drag this way. We just have it as a rectangle here, something like this. Yeah, this is good. This looks great. And after this, as I told you, the user can perform multiple actions. So first, let me go with the obvious action, that is ordering food. So first thing, the user just goes here. The user can search for a restaurant or a dish. So in some cases, the user searches a restaurant and orders a dish, and in some cases, the user directly searches the dish and orders from a particular restaurant. So it can be either the way. The search can be like unpredictable. It just depends on the user. So it's going to be search hotel or restaurant or dish. Can be both. So once the user has done searching it, the user will select the dish. Okay, the user can select or deselect. So I'll just have it add to cart. So this should include both selecting and deselecting that particular dish. So once the user has done selecting the necessary dishes or food, the user can like generate the bill. The bill will be generated. Bill generated. So this is the place where the user can apply coupons, the tax, the delivery time, and how many extra additional charges in case if it's there is a rain or the distance is too long. All the things will be calculated in this bill and will appear in front of the user. And here the user will also be prompted to select the mode of payment, whether it is an online transaction or cash on delivery. The user can select that particular thing in this bin generated path. Okay, action there. After this, just payment. So payment. After this, the user can just log out. In case of a online system, the user can directly do online transaction and just basically log out after this. So this is done. This is the standard flow of a person who's going to order food in an online food ordering system. And apart from this, the next action that a user can perform in a food ordering system is edit the details. Because in food ordering system, we have the email and we have the mobile number and we have the most importantly the address. So the user can also just change the details and just come outside of the app. So here I will just have edit details. So this is also an action that the user can do, and the user can order dishes after that or just can log out after editing the details. You can even have updating details. That word will suit more, something else, something like that. Yeah, this is good. And the next action that the user will perform is cancel. Okay, cancel an order. So if that particular food hasn't been delivered yet, the user can view the status. First thing is status. View the status of the particular order. So after the like the bill has been paid by the user can view the status also. So how far is the food from the home or the location to be delivered? The duration, the distance that is going to take to deliver this food. So that can be viewed over there. And in case if that particular food is yet to be delivered, the user can cancel. Okay? Cancel order. Yeah. And after that, the user can just log out. So this is also an action that can be done by the user. And apart from this, you can just add another thing over here. You can just add that another thing inside. I think edit details, it's fine. You don't want to have a separate action, which is view order history. So this will basically have the food that the user has ordered from which restaurant on a which date, how much was the bill, literally every single detail about that particular order. So the user can just view this also. If you want, you can just have this over here. It's totally up to you, but I will just have it inside it because this is quite related to the details, because details, you will have it in the same column, right? Details history. So it comes under the same menu bar or options. So you can just have it somewhere over here. So now I'm good. Now let me just have here a merge, which is, and now let me just have a join thing, which is similar to fork, but this is used to like compress multiple actions into a single one. So after this, we will be just having logout, and after that we'll be having this thing called as final. So I'll just draw the arrow lines now. So I have just drawn the arrow lines, and if I just now zoom it out a bit, so this is basically the online food ordering system. I think it's short and sweet and simple. So if you have any other changes to be done or any other opinion regarding this diagram or any other add-ons, you can just mention in the comments below. And do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of class diagrams, activity diagrams, and use case diagrams and many more things, and programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries, Fedora operations as well. So check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.